Students, today we are going to discuss about the next lesson, that is ecosystem. So students, see here, which factors do you found in our surrounding? Second question is, are these factors directly or indirectly related to you? So see here students, there are so many factors are present in our surrounding, out of which some are living factors or some are non-living factors, and these all factors are directly or indirectly related to us or related to each other. So see here students, sunlight, sunflower, elephant, lotus, algae, stone, grass, water, ant, soil, cat, fern, air and lime. These are the some factors. You have to classify these factors into living factors and non-living factors. We know that sunflower, elephant, lotus, algae, grass, cat, fern, lion, these are the living factors and others are the non-living factors. So now we see what is mean by ecosystem. So see here students, in world around us is made up of living and non-living factors. Living factors are also called as biotic factors and non-living factors are also called as abiotic factors. Living means biotic and non-living means abiotic factors. There is a continuous interaction between these living and non-living factors regarding their habitat, environment, and all these things are correlated with each other. So see here student, the structure which is formed due to these reciprocal relationships is called an ecosystem. Means the biotic factors and abiotic factors are directly or indirectly related with each other. So structure of these formed by the reciprocal interrelationship between these factors are called as ecosystem. So biotic and abiotic factors and their interactions form an ecosystem. So see here students, these are the components of ecosystem. See here, the main components of ecosystems are biotic factors and second is abiotic factors. First of all, we see the biotic factors. So in biotic factors, there are two main subtypes, that is physical factors and chemical factors. So in physical factors, air, water vapors, minerals, soil, sunlight, these factors are related. And in chemical factors are also divided into two types or two subgroups, that is inorganic substances and organic substances. So inorganic substances, hydrogen, oxygen, nitrogen, calcium, iron, potassium and sodium, these types of substances are come together. And proteins, carbohydrates and lipids, these are the organic substances. So this is all about the abiotic factors. Next we see the biotic factors. So in biotic factors is also divided into two subtypes. First one is autotrophic and second one is heterotrophic. First of all, we see what is mean by autotrophic. So all of you know that meaning of autotrophic is that the factors or the living things which produces their own food is called as autotrophic, and meaning of heterotrophic is that the living factors are depend for food on another living organisms are called as heterotrophic. म्हणजे हे अन्नासाठी दुसऱ्यांवरती डिपेंड असतात आणि ऑटोट्रॉप्स मीन्स दीज प्रोड्युसेस देअर ओन फूड. सो इन ॲटोट्रॉपिक एक्झाम्पल्स ऑफ ॲटोट्रॉपिक्स आर कॉल्ड ॲज प्रोड्युसर्स. सो ऑल द प्लांट्स आर अकोमोडेटेड इन द प्रोड्युसर्स. सो नेक्स्ट वी सी द ऑटोट्रॉपिक प्लांट्स और ऑटोट्रॉपिक लिविंग ऑर्गॅनिझम्स. सो सी हियर स्टूडंट्स, इन ऑटोट्रॉपिक देअर आर टू टाईप्स, कंज्युमर्स अँड डीकंपोजर्स. सो कंज्युमर्स विच आर डिपेंड ऑन अनदर लिविंग ऑर्गॅनिझम फॉर फूड, अँड कंज्युमर मीन्स द लिविंग ऑर्गॅनिझम्स विच आर डिपेंडंट ऑन द अदर डेड बॉडीज ऑफ लिविंग ऑर्गॅनिझम, अँड दॅट मायक्रोब्स आर कॉल्ड ॲज कंज्युमर्स बिकॉज दे डिकम्पोजेस द डेड बॉडी ऑफ एनी अदर लिविंग थिंग्स. सो सी हियर, कंज्युमर्स आर also called as animals. So these consumers are also divided into three types, that is, first one is primary consumer, second one is secondary consumer, and third one is tertiary consumer. So this type of consumers are depending upon the type and the position of that animal in an ecosystem. So the types are primary, secondary and tertiary. Third type is decomposers, or the microorganisms which decomposes the dead body of another living organism, that microorganisms are called as decomposers. So this is all about the composition of ecosystem. So next we see the structure of an ecosystem. So see here, living organism need different types of abiotic factors, and they have different capacities to adapt with those biotic factors. Some microbes needs oxygen while others don't. Some plant needs sunlight while other grow well in shade. So see here, this is the structure. Each and every biotic factors means air, water, soil, sunlight, temperature, etc., affects the biotic factors in an ecosystem. The biotic factors in an ecosystem decide which biotic factor will survive in it and what will be their number. The proportion of biotic factors in an ecosystem is always changing. Their changing biotic factors, use of excrete abiotic factors, every biotic factors affects the biotic factors as well as other biotic factors around it. Every living organism in an ecosystem plays an particular role while living, moving in that ecosystem. So the position of any living organism in context to other living organism and the role it is playing is called niche. What is called niche? So example is sunflower plant in a garden evolves oxygen in the air and provides food and shelter for insects like ants and honeybees. So this is the niche of a sunflower plant. So role of any organism and context to other living organism and the role it plays that particular living organism is called as niche. So next we see the interaction among factors of an ecosystem. So see here, abiotic factors, nutrients, solar energy, carbon dioxide, nitrogen, water and minerals, these are present in air. So by the process of photosynthesis, food production, biotic factors means plants are grown, and at that time heat is evolved out, and next these plants are eaten by primary, secondary and tertiary consumers because animals consume food from plants. At that time heat is released out, and after the death of these abiotic factors, these biotic factors means the primary, secondary and tertiary consumers, after death of these animals, the microbes that are called as decomposers, or the microbes decomposes their dead bodies, and by the process of decomposition minerals are released into the soil, and at that time heat is also evolved in the surrounding. Next, so these are the microbes which decomposes the death body, and at that time also heat is evolved, and because of these minerals which are mixed in the soil, and the next plants are uses these minerals which are mixed in the soil for their growth, and this cycle is continuously ongoing. So this is all about the interaction among factors of an ecosystem. So next we see here, most of the ecosystems are complex and there is tremendous quantitative and qualitative variety of species in them. In ecosystem of tropical country like India, few species of living organisms are found everywhere in a large number. Remaining species of plants and animals are found in a small number. Some species are very few number. Variety of ecosystems is found on earth, that is forest, pond, ocean, rivers, etc. Types of ecosystems are formed according to size, place, climate and types of plants and animals. Many types of ecosystems are found in biosphere. Their specific functions continue according to their environment, though these ecosystems look dependent and different, they are linked to each other directly or indirectly. Therefore, we cannot separate these small ecosystems from each other, but can classify them according to their functions. So see here student, some region on earth, a large area has same climate and abiotic factors. These living organisms in those area are also similar. So specific ecosystems developed in a vast area, such large ecosystems are called as biomes. What is called as biomes means some म्हणजे अर्थवरती एखाद्या स्पेसिफिक रिजनमध्ये सेम क्लायमेट आणि सेम अबायोटिक फॅक्टर्स प्रेझेंट असतात आणि अशा एरियामध्ये राहणारे जे काही लिव्हिंग ऑर्गॅनिझम्स असतात हे देखील सेम असतात आणि अशा एरियाजमध्ये जी इकोसिस्टीम डेव्हलप होते दॅट इकोसिस्टीम ऑर दॅट लार्ज इकोसिस्टीम इज कॉल्ड ॲज बायोम्स. सो नाऊ वी आर गोइंग टू स्टडी द डिफरंट टाईप्स ऑफ बायोम्स दॅट इज लँड बायोम अँड अक्वॅटिक बायोम. फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल वी डिस्कस अबाउट दी लँड बायोम्स. सो वॉट इज मीन बाय लँड बायोम्स? द बायोम्स विच एक्झिस्ट ओनली ऑन लँड आर कॉल्ड ॲज लँड बायोम्स. म्हणजे जमिनीवरती असणारी बायोम्स. ड्यू टू अनइक्वल डिस्ट्रीब्युशन ऑफ अबायोटिक फॅक्टर्स डिफरंट टाईप्स ऑफ इकोसिस्टीम्स एक्झिस्ट दॅट इज ग्रासलँड, एव्हरग्रीन फॉरेस्ट, डेझर्ट, आइसलँड इकोसिस्टीम, इकोसिस्टीम्स इन तैगा, ट्रॉपिकल रेन फॉरेस्ट. दीज आर दी डिफरंट टाईप्स ऑफ लँड बायोम्स आर प्रेझेंट ऑन लँड बिकॉज ऑफ दी अनइक्वल डिस्ट्रीब्युशन ऑफ बायोटिक अँड अबायोटिक फॅक्टर्स ऑन लँड डिपेंडिंग अपॉन देअर टेम्परेचर अँड क्लायमेटिक फॅक्टर्स ऑन दॅट स्पेसिफिक एरिया ऑर रिजन. सो फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल वी सी द ग्रासलँड बायोम. सो ग्रासलँड डेव्हलप्स वेल, ग्रासलँड डेव्हलप्स वेअर द रेनफॉल इज नॉट इनफ टू ग्रो बिग ट्रीज. फास्ट ग्रोथ ऑफ ग्रास इज फाउंड इन दिस इकोसिस्टीम. म्हणजे ज्या ठिकाणी पाऊस आहे परंतु तो पाऊस किती असेल की बिग ट्रीजसाठी जितका पाऊस लागतो त्यापेक्षा कमी, की गवत म्हणजे ग्रासच्या ग्रोईंगसाठी जितका पाऊस लागेल तितका पाऊस ज्या एरियाजमध्ये प्रेझेंट आहे सो दॅट एरियाज ग्रास इकोसिस्टीम इज सीन देअर. सो सी अ लॉंगर समर अँड लिमिटेड रेन डेव्हलप डॉर्फ प्लांट इन दीज एरियाज. ॲनिमल्स लाईक गोट, शीप, जिराफ, झेब्रा, इलेफंट, डियर, चितळ, टायगर इट्सेट्रा आर फाउंड इन दिस टाईप ऑफ इकोसिस्टीम. सिमिलरली बर्ड्स, इन्सेक्ट्स अँड मायक्रोब्स आर अल्सो प्रेझेंट इन दॅट टाईप ऑफ ग्रासलँड इकोसिस्टीम. सो नेक्स्ट वी सी एव्हरग्रीन फॉरेस्ट. सो इट इज अ नॅचरल इकोसिस्टीम वेअर व्हरायटी ऑफ प्लांट्स, ॲनिमल्स अँड बायोटिक फॅक्टर्स आर फाउंड. सो दिस इज अल्सो कॉल्ड ॲज फॉरेस्ट इकोसिस्टीम. सो इन इंडिया देअर आर सम नॅशनल पार्क्स अँड ऑर सँक्चुअरीज प्रेझेंट इन इंडिया. सो देअर इज अ लिस्ट स्टुडंट, यू हॅव टू यू हॅव टू नो दॅट वेअर दीज नॅशनल पार्क्स ऑर सँक्चुअरीज आर प्रेझेंट इन इंडिया. सो सी हियर फर्स्ट नॅशनल पार्क इज ऑर सँक्चुअरी इज गीर. सो दिस गीर नॅशनल पार्क इज प्रेझेंट इन द स्टेट गुजरात ऑफ इंडिया. सेकेंड इज दॅचिगम. दॅट दॅचिगम नॅशनल पार्क इज प्रेझेंट इन द स्टेट जम्मू अँड काश्मीर. व्हाईल रणथंबोर इज प्रेझेंट इन राजस्थान. दाजीपूर इज प्रेझेंट इन महाराष्ट्र. वेअर काझीरंगा आर अल्सो प्रेझेंट इन स्टेट आसाम ऑफ इंडिया. सो दीज आर दी डिफरंट नॅशनल पार्क्स ऑर सँक्चुरीज प्रेझेंट इन इंडिया. सो दिस टाईप ऑफ सँक्चुरीज आर कॉल्ड ॲज एव्हरग्रीन फॉरेस्ट. सो नेक्स्ट वी सी द सेकेंड biome, that is aquatic biome. So what, now we see what is mean by aquatic biomes. So see here students, out of 71% of the earth's surface is covered by water and only 29% of land on it. All of you know that there is 71% of earth's surface is occupied by water only. Therefore, study of aquatic biomes is very, very important. According to the area, aquatic biomes are widespread than land bioscope. So in aquatic biomes, there are different types of ecosystem present depending on the potability of water or types of water. First are freshwater ecosystem, marine water ecosystem, and creek ecosystem. So first we see the freshwater ecosystem. So in freshwater ecosystem, ponds, lakes, rivers are included in this type of ecosystem. The transition of energy in this ecosystem is through water currents and rivers. Next, decomposers are at the bottom of water reservoirs, and these decomposers decomposes the dead bodies of plant and animals and convert it into abiotic factors. Okay, so this is all about the freshwater ecosystem. Next is marine ecosystem. So see here student, what is mean by marine ecosystem? Marine plants grow in these type of ecosystems are called as marine ecosystems. Shallow water contains small fishes, prawns feeding on algae. The central part of sea has less number of aquatic organisms. Large fishes are secondary consumers. Ocean has a large amount of nutrients. So these the bottom of ocean has more number of decomposers and dead bodies of plants and animals and waste materials are decomposes by the different microbes or bacteria. So see here, जे मराइन प्लांट्स आहेत, हे मराइन प्लांट्स म्हणजे खाऱ्या पाण्यातले जे काही मासे आहेत ते, किंवा खाऱ्या पाण्यातली वनस्पती, हे सगळे या पाण्यामध्ये असतात. या पाण्यामधील जे फिशेस वगैरे असतील ते आपण शक्यतो खात नाही. ओके, सो दिस इज ऑल अबाउट दी मराइन इकोसिस्टीम. सो नेक्स्ट we see, next point is diminishment of ecosystem due to human interference. Next paha, ata he kay ahe ki baba apla manvi hastakshep jo ahe, ya manvi hastakshepamule ecosystem cha imbalance kasa hoto te baghayche. Many human activities have side effects on functions of ecosystem and cause their diminishment. Means mining and excessive cutting of trees changes the use of land. So interaction between biotic and abiotic factors are also affected. So there are many things or many human activities which diminishes the environment and as well as ecosystem. So activities like cutting of trees, different human activities have different effects on of ecosystem. They can be transformation of an ecosystem from one to another, extinction of species. So see here, which what are the effects of human interference in an ecosystem? So see here, first effect is that increasing use of resources due to increased population. Humans are the consumers in an ecosystem. Ecosystem can provide basic needs in normal conditions. Due to increased population, man kept snatching natural resources on large scale, changing lifestyle and demands more than necessary. That has increased stress on the ecosystem and has generated vast amounts of waste. So see here, there is a big population of humans present on earth, and to complete the needs, human interfere the environment or increases the use of resources from environment, and because of that or because of the changing the lifestyle of humans, the man interfere the environment or ecosystem. So next, second activity is urbanization. Due to continuous process of urbanization, more and more agricultural lands, marshlands, wetlands, forest and grasslands are being destroyed for the buildings and other basic facilities or for the companies. As a result, human interference ecosystem either change or get completely destroyed, or urbanization or industrialization. So next point is industrialization and traffic. Raw materials required for industrializations are obtained by the destroying forest. This results in destruction of forest, or indirectly this results in destruction of evergreen ecosystem. To provide the amenities for increased traffic, many times roads and railways are built through forest and wetlands. So next point is tourism. People visit many places for snake, for nature watch, environment and visit to scared places, and lot of amenities are created for these tourists. This cause destruction of local ecosystem due to increased stress. See here, jyaala tourism madhe je kai places ahet ki ja thikani apun visit karto, tya thikani visit kelyanantar titli ji kai ecosystem asel ti ecosystem kay hote, collapse houn jate. Kashamule? Pratyek goshticha stress tya thikani tithe yet asto, kiwa jo kai interference apla humans cha एन्वायरमेंट मध्ये किंवा इकोसिस्टीम मध्ये होत राहतो, तो वाढत राहतो आणि त्याच्यामुळे इकोसिस्टीम जी आहे ही काय होते, डॅमेज होते. सो नेक्स्ट, लार्ज डॅम्स. डॅम्स ओव्हर कवर वास्ट लँड्स, सो द फॉरेस्ट और ग्रासलँड इन दॅट एरिया गेट कन्वर्टेड इनटू अक्वॅटिक इकोसिस्टीम. डॅम्स ऑल्सो लेसन the water current in lower area. So and the last point is that wars, differences and competition over land and water mineral resources, or some economic and political reasons lead to war among human races. Manje जे काही कॉम्पिटिशन आहे लँडसाठी, वॉटरसाठी, मिनरल्ससाठी, मायनिंगसाठी, याच्यामध्ये किंवा याच्या पाठीमागचे रिझन्स काय असतील, इकॉनॉमिकल रिझन और पॉलिटिकल रिझन्स, बिकॉज ऑफ दॅट वॉर्स, इट लीड्स वॉर अमंग ह्युमन रेसेस. हेवी बॉम्बिंग अँड माइन एक्सप्लोजन्स आर डन इन वॉर्स. दीज आर not only life threatening but also change or destroy natural ecosystems. Wars mule ye kay hotat जी काही नॅचरल सिस्टीम आहे ती नॅचरल सिस्टीम टोटली इट डॅमेजेस. सी नेक्स्ट, थस नॅचरल डिझास्टर्स लाईक अर्थक्वेक, वल्कॅनो, फ्लड, ड्रट्स अँड ह्युमन इंटरफेरन्स रिझल्ट इन द डिस्ट्रक्शन ऑफ इकोसिस्टीम. सो यू मस्ट हॅव टू प्रोटेक्ट नॅचरल इकोसिस्टीम अँड maintain the balance between the biosphere. Because of that we are not suffering from the many activities of environment and we live neatly. So student, lesson is completed here. You must have to solve this exercise in your notebook, and if you have any doubt regarding this lesson, you must ask me. Thank you.